The threat for hurricanes in the near future is rapidly increasing because right now, the Atlantic Ocean is hotter than it's ever been before, and hot oceans are like jet fuel for hurricanes. But things are currently very quiet in the tropics. There's something stopping big storms from forming. In this video, I'm going to explain what that thing is and what's going to happen when it goes away. The Atlantic Ocean is like a ticking time bomb right now with all of these crazy sea surface temperatures. We've been keeping track of this stuff since 1854, and no other year comes close to comparing with what we're dealing with right now. Just look at this map showing where the waters are warmer than usual. Everything is steaming hot out there. One of the hottest spots is down here near Florida, where just the other day a 98.5 degree water temperature was recorded. 98.5, that's like a daggone hot tub. And we can even zoom way out and continue to see those 90 degree waters across a huge region of the Atlantic. This is not normal and could lead to disaster if a hurricane was able to interact with it. Check out this map showing the current maximum hurricane potential out there. If given the perfect conditions, a huge chunk of the Atlantic could support a Category 4 or 5 hurricane right now. And the crazy thing is, we are at the very beginning of hurricane season. We are nowhere near the peak or when the waters are supposed to be at their hottest. But if things are really that primed for hurricanes out there, then where are all the hurricanes? You see, things are pretty calm right now, mainly due to a combination of Saharan dust and vertical wind shear, which stunt the growth of tropical storms. The larger deterrent of these two is wind shear, which is basically when all the winds up in the atmosphere start changing speed and direction with height. And there's a large area of that happening around the Caribbean currently, and it's acting as a shield, keeping all the big storms away. And earlier this year, we thought this pattern would carry through the entire season due to the fact that El Nino was ramping up. You see, when the waters around the equatorial Pacific start getting really warm like they are right now, we call that El Nino. And with El Nino, you'll get a bunch of storm activity over here in the Pacific, leading to a lot of hostile trade winds and wind shear in the Atlantic. So with the forecast calling for a strong El Nino just a few months ago, it was seemingly safe to say that this wind shear would continue, therefore leading to an average or slightly below average hurricane season. But things are starting to change as new forecast data is coming out. We're still going to have an El Nino, but it's looking less likely that this one will become excessively strong. The waters in the Pacific might only get moderately warmer than usual, leading to less frequent storms around the equator, and therefore less overall trade winds and wind shear. If these upper air winds calm down even for a little bit, our ticking time bomb could explode. And I think that's more likely to happen with a weaker El Nino in place. Any storm that's allowed to form in this environment will likely turn into a monster and cause big problems for whoever it comes into contact with. There's plenty of ocean heat content out there, which is the food that hurricanes need to thrive. And speaking of food, let's shout out today's sponsor, Factor, America's number one ready-to-eat meal kit. Y'all, it is officially summer. You're out there having fun in the sun, you're in the pool, you're throwing parties, you're cooking out, you're playing sports, and all that activity is gonna make you hungry. But that's actually great news because today's sponsor, Factor, is all about delivering you the best nutritious and invigorating meals to help keep you on top of your game all this summer. Longtime fans of the channel will know that I love these homemade meal services. That's why I just had to tell you about Factor, because they're actually now owned by HelloFresh, and you guys know how much I love HelloFresh. Factor's fresh, never frozen meals are ready in just 2 minutes, so all you gotta do is heat and eat. And not only is Factor quicker than takeout, its weekly recipe rotation ensures that there's always a meal to satisfy your lifestyle, whether you're vegetarian, vegan, or just plain old hungry. And the team here at the Weather House has grown to love these things, serving as a quick and easy way to fuel up during intense forecasting or editing sessions. Go to factor75.com right now, or just hit that link in the description, and you're going to be able to use my code, y'all50, to get 50% off. So, I mean, why wouldn't you do that? Go do it right now, and then let's get back into the video. With all this new forecast data coming in, the outlook for the rest of hurricane season is looking more and more concerning. And it's not just me saying this. Even the hurricane experts at Colorado State University are agreeing with me. Just the other day, they updated their official 2023 hurricane forecast to reflect this new information. In April, the university only thought there was going to be around 13 named cyclones, 6 hurricanes, and three major hurricanes. And the reason for these somewhat low numbers was partly because of El Nino's wind shear influence across the Atlantic. But after seeing these new projections, along with the unprecedented warmth in the Atlantic, they upped everything. Now, according to Colorado State University, we are expecting up to 18 named storms, 9 hurricanes, and 4 major hurricanes. This is a big difference and would actually classify this season as an above average hurricane season if it verifies. On top of that, their new forecast states that the mainland U.S. is at greater risk than usual for experiencing a direct hit from a major hurricane. Usually, the probability of a direct hit by a Cat 3 Plus here in the States is around 43%, and this new outlook is boasting a bold 50% chance. And I agree with the meteorologists at Colorado State University. In fact, I would go as far to say they might still be conservative even with their new updated forecast. And I'll just go ahead and put it out there that I think that we could see 19 named storms, 10 of those being hurricanes, and 5 being major hurricanes. And the reason why I think we could see up to 5 major hurricanes, category 3 or higher, is because of the massive amount of energy that's out there. If these storms do actually form, a lot of them are going to get very strong very quickly. Even if we don't see 18 or 19 named storms, and we only see 14, 15, or 16, I still think 5 major hurricanes is a possibility because of the locked and loaded nature of the Atlantic Ocean right now. I think that August and September will be very active, and we will get to that 18th named storm very quickly. The tricky part is determining how many of those will actually threaten land masses, and that's something that we're going to have to take one storm at a time. But due to the extreme warmth in these waters that surround the U.S., it's hard to imagine a scenario where a big storm doesn't at least try to persist. And that extreme warmth is more than likely going to counteract some of the negative El Nino influences we would typically depend on to lessen the blow. Couple that with the increasing chance that at some point we see a slight break in the wind shear overall, and you can see why I am making this video. I'm afraid that the slow start and the original lackluster forecasts may be making people turn a blind eye to the tropics this year. I believe that the Atlantic is basically a powder keg right now, and if it's allowed to ignite, the boom will be massive. So please don't sleep on this hurricane season. If I lived along the coast, I would be using this quiet period right now to prepare by going over my hurricane plans, evacuation routes, and touching base with my insurance agent. Sure, there's a chance that this ticking time bomb or this powder keg, whatever you want to call it, there's a chance that it doesn't ignite. Even moderate El Ninos are notorious for taking down hurricane seasons. It's actually hard to find examples of major hurricanes that hit the U.S. during moderate to strong El Ninos. But I promise y'all, there's never been an El Nino year where we've had such warm waters in the Atlantic. Therefore, it doesn't really matter what's happened in the past because there is no expected atmospheric response. So I say it's better to be safe than sorry, as we are literally in uncharted waters here. Please help me spread the word about this updated forecast by sharing this video on social media or liking it here on YouTube, and of course, hit that subscribe button. If a big ol' hurricane does start churning out there, I'll be relaying constant updates right here on YouTube, and of course, if there's a U.S. landfall, we're gonna go live with storm chasers out there in the middle of it. And remember, the most important thing, don't be scared, be prepared, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. Ooh.